One of the major marketing points of the Kia EV6 has been the 800-volt ultra-fast charging technology, and its claim to charge from 10% to 80% in just 18 minutes. In this video, I'll perform a charging test to find out if that's really true. You'll be surprised by the results. I performed this charge test on a road trip we did through California's Gold Country. If you'd like to see how the EV6 performs on a road trip, click on the link in the top right of your screen to watch that video. I'll bring you into the point where we've just arrived at the charge station in Placerville with only 10% charge and 24 miles of range remaining. The outside temperature is 59 degrees Fahrenheit, and we had just arrived after driving for about 60 miles. Okay, so we're here at our charging stop. We've arrived with 10% battery, so we're gonna do a charge test and see how long it takes to get to 80% and then to 100%. So here we go. And then I've got to open up the Electrify America app. And I hope this works because we have nowhere else to go. Okay. This is charger number 4. Swipe to start charge. Initiating charging.
Turn on the juice.
Okay, I think it's charging. It's charging. To save you the agony of sitting through the entire charge session to 100%, I put together a chart showing the charge power and the battery state of charge. The charge power is in blue and the state of charge in orange. Right off the bat, the charging gets up to a respectable range of 120 to 127 kilowatt. It hangs out there for about 3 minutes, at which point it jumps into the 200 kilowatt range at minute 4. It holds there for another 3 minutes or so. By now, the state of charge is already in the mid-30s in just 6 to 7 minutes of charging. Over the next 2 minutes, it begins a steep climb right up to 236 kilowatt. And then it hits 241 kilowatt. Or 240.35 kilowatt to be precise, as shown on the Electrify America session summary. Now that is the maximum charge power input as stated by Kia's spec sheet. So I think it's pretty impressive that this car hit that number. It holds in the 235 to 241 range for about 3 to 4 minutes. By now, it's reached a 50% state of charge in just a little over 10 minutes. But then the charge drops off significantly into the 150 kilowatt range, presumably because the battery has reached its maximum temperature. It stays there for another couple of minutes and then drops further into the 130 kilowatt range for another couple minutes. It's now been about 5 minutes since the peak of 240 kilowatt, and presumably the battery temperature has recovered, so the peak power jumps back up to 170 kilowatt for a couple of minutes. At the 18-minute mark, the power is at 157 kilowatt, and the state of charge at 75%. Not quite the 80% per Kia's claim. But 80% is not so far away, and it gets there at the 20-minute mark. Still very impressive in my opinion, to go from 10% to 80% charge in just 20 minutes. By the 20-minute mark, the power has been steadily dropping and it is at 114 kilowatt. From there on, the power starts a slow decline and by the 25th minute, it's at 52 kilowatt. At the same time, the state of charge is at 89%. From there on, it slows down even further to protect the battery. The final 100% state of charge is reached at minute 45, and the power is down to a measly 11 kilowatts. What's really interesting to see when you look at the two graphs against each other is that despite the wild gyrations of the power graph up to 80%, the state of charge graph is almost a smooth linear graph. I'm no electrical or battery engineer, but I believe that is a testament to the battery management system and how it's ensuring that the battery health is protected despite the varying power inputs. Once it gets past 80%, both the power and state of charge graphs are a smooth slowdown of both power and state of charge. Honestly, I was a little taken aback by these numbers. I wasn't quite expecting to hit these peaks just on my second DC charging experience, but I'm really happy that it did. Even though it didn't hit 80% in 18 minutes, in my books, this validates Kia's 800-volt technology and its claim to ultra-fast charging. I hope you enjoyed this analysis, and please be sure to check out my other Kia EV6 videos. Please subscribe and consider supporting me on Patreon or buy me a coffee. Please give the video a like, share your comments below, and subscribe to the Driver Download.